semester mathematics complex analysis lecture 1 by Dr. Ramulu, head department of mathematics, MTS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. Nagar. So, antiderivative. The topic is antiderivative. A function capital F of J is said to be antiderivative of small f of J on contour C if capital F dash of J equal to small f of J. So I'm taking f of J that equal to J square, capital F of J equal to J cube by 3. How I am taking this? If I integrate in this function, we will get this. So we have to write integration of this thing. So if I differentiate capital F dash of J, that equal to 3 J square by 3. If nothing but 3 J will cancel out J square, that equal to small f of Z. Therefore, f of j, here f of j is antiderivative of small f of j. Example, other example, if I take sin j, what is the integration of sin j? Minus 4j, right? So minus 4j, I am taking that is capital F of j. So if I derivate this f, capital F of j, we will get f dash of j equal to minus all in j. What is the derivative of j? Minus sin j. Minus sin j minus minus plus 2, that equals sin j. Sin j equal to small f of z. Therefore, f of j is antiderivative of small f of j. Antiderivative theorem. Statement, right? Suppose that a function f of j is continuous from on a domain D if any one of the following statement are true. If one is true, other is true. A. F of j is antiderivative of capital F of j throughout D. Then the integration of small f of j along contour lying entirely in D, extending from any point, any fixed point z1 to any fixed point z2, all have the same values. That means integration z1 over z2 f of j dz equal to capital F of z1 z2, that equal to f of z2 minus f of z1, where capital F of z is antiderivative of f of z, right? So proof you can do your own, otherwise I will send through copy of the proof. Okay, some problems. Okay, evaluate 0 to 1 plus I z square dz. What is the antiderivative of z square z cube by 3, right? By using antiderivative theorem, integration 0 to 1 plus I z square dz equal to z cube by 3, 0 to 1 plus I. So in case of getting substitute 1 plus I whole cube minus 0, that equal to 3, equal to 1 plus I whole cube, that equal to 3, right? So factor number 15. By finding an antiderivative, evaluate each of these intervals where the curve is any contour between integrated limits of integration. A. I to I by 2 e power pi z dz. B. 0 to pi plus 2 I 4 z z by 2 dz. C. 1 to 3 z minus z minus 2 whole cube dz. A. Evaluate each of these interval by using antiderivative theorem given between the limits. Principles: one is contour, second is contour interval, third is antiderivative theorem. Method: f of j equal to pi. What is the antiderivative of j? Already know that this is continuous. Every exponential function is continuous. Therefore, this also e power pi z is also continuous. I am taking f of z. What is the integration of z, right? What is the integration of e pi z e power pi z by pi? F dash of z equal to pi e power pi z by pi. So pi by z cancel out, e power pi z, e power pi z is equal small f of z. Therefore, capital F of z is an antiderivative of small f of j. So by using antiderivative theorem, I to I by 2 small f of j dz equal to capital F of z z1 to z2, z1 equal to I, z2 equal to I by 2. I'm substituting these values here. Okay, what is capital F of z? E power pi z by pi, e power pi z by pi. So I'm substituting z equal to I here, e power I pi by 2, pi minus e power I pi pi plus I sin pi. E power I pi by 2 equal to I. E power I pi equal to minus 1. I'm substituting this value. E power I pi by 2 nothing but I. E power I pi by 2 minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1. We will get 1 by pi 1 plus I. So D. 0 to pi plus 2 I 4 z by 2 dz. F of z equal to 4 z by 2. Clearly, cosine is continuous. Cosine is continuous, we can, it is integrable. That's why I am taking the capital F of z equal to, what is the integration of cosine to 2 sin z by 2. Right? So, I am taking like this, F of z. F dash of z, by differentiating this, F dash of z equal to 2 cosine by 2 into 1 by 2, that equal to 4 z by 2 equal to F of z. Capital F of z is, antiderivative of I, then antiderivative of small f of z. So, integration of, by using antiderivative theorem, integration of f of z dz equal to f of z upper lower limit to upper limit. So, I am substituting capital F of z equal to what? 2 sin z by 2, right? Pi plus 2i. I want to substitute this value here, pi plus 2i to minus 0 cos, simply write sin z equal to 0, will get here already 0, 2 sin pi plus 2i by 2. So, I am dividing this by pi plus 2 by pi. So, by using extension of sin a plus b, so we will get this extension. So, here cos pi by 2 nothing but 0, sin pi by 2 nothing but 1, we will get 2 cos I. C, 1 to 3, z minus 2 whole cube dz, f of z equal to z minus 2 whole cube. Clearly, this is Polynomial function, it is continuous. Therefore, I am taking f of z equal to z minus 2 whole power 4 by 4. That means the integration of this. If I take the differentiation of this, f dash of z equal to 4 times of z cancel of z minus 2 whole cube. This is nothing but small f of z. F of z, therefore f of z is an antiderivative of f of z, small f of z. By using antiderivative of 1 to 3, f of z dz, here f of z dz, that equal to capital F of z 1 to 3. What is capital F of z? Capital F of z nothing but this. 1 to 3. I am substituting this value here. We get 1 by 4 over 2 minus 1 by 4 over 2. That means 1 by 4, 1 by 4 over 2 will get minus plus will get capital, that equal to 0. That means integration of this equal to 0. Result, we have evaluated the following integral, that means a equal to 0. The integration of a equal to 0, that means value can write here. In case of a, the integral value right. In case of b, the integral value right here. In case of c, the integral value right here. So, practice problem 16. This antiderivative to show that for every contour C extending a point z1 to a point z2. Show that integration C z power and dz equal to this thing n equal to 1, 2, 3, right? Right, then you have to show that by using antiderivative a, right? A equal to, then you have to show that this expression by using antiderivative theorem. Principle. Right, contour integral and antiderivative theorems. Previous problem I explained that only, right? Method. Let C be any contour between given point z1 to z2. I am taking f of z equal to z power n. This polynomial can be discriminated continuous. That's why I am taking capital F of z equal to z power n plus 1, n plus 1, right? If I differentiate this, we will get n plus 1 by n plus 1, n plus 1, yes, that's allowed, z power n. Z power n nothing but f of j. F of j is antiderivative of small f of j. So, by using antiderivative theorem, it is in C, f of j, dz equal to capital F of j, z1, z2. So, what is f of j? F of j nothing but z power n plus 1 by n plus 1. I am substituting the values here. In place of z, z2, we will get z2 over n plus 1. In place of z, n plus z1, right, we will get, right? So, this expression, we have to prove the result. We shown that this is good by using antiderivative theorem, which is contour from z1 to z2. So, problem I want to write, so show that minus 1 to 1, z power I, dz equal to this, where the integral denotes the principal branch of z power I exponential of I log z. This z power nothing but exponential of I log z. O log z. F of z equal to z power I. Capital F of z equal to z power I plus 1 by I plus 1. So, if that was z equal to what happened, if a differentiate this equal to z power n nothing but small f of z. So, small f of z So capital F of it is another value of mode F of it. By using that theorem, we can write here integration of input capital F of Z. F of Z nothing but capital Z plus I, Z root 4 I plus 1 equal by I plus 1 minus 1 to Y. What is right Z equal to 1 plus Z equal to 1 4 I plus 1 Z equal to minus 1 we will get here. So this directly equal to this 1 by I plus 1. So 1 by I plus 1 minus of minus 1 whole power of I plus 1. So what we know that Z power I equal exponential of I log Z. Here Z 1 power of I plus 1. This can be written as exponential of I plus 1 log 1. Here also minus 1 whole power I plus 1 exponential of log 1. This is capital log 1, right? So we can write capital log 1 equal to log 1 plus I 0. Capital log minus 1 equal to log 1 plus I 5. So this is branch of logarithm. So log 1 equal to 0, so e power of integer 0, that equal to e power 0, e power 0 is about 1. Log 1 equal to 0, I 5 is so the simple way is e power of minus 5 into e power of 5. E power minus 5 equal to e power minus 5, e power minus, minus 5 is about minus 1. Minus 1 will cancel out, plus we get. So this is equal to this expression we will get. So what I did here, I am rationalizing. So the final value we get here 1 plus e power minus 5 by 2 1 minus 5. This expression we have to show. So this end of the syllabus unit 2.